This program is rated universal. Good for general watching.
Sportswoman is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Our viewers, welcome to Sportswoman. My name is Becky Cynthia Nachmara, and I'm with Faith Mirelle PI, with Sharon Adong. Welcome once again. I want to remind you about the Harvest Money Expo that is scheduled on the 14th February to 16th at Nambole. Entrance is 20,000 with training, and without training, that is 10,000 shillings. You can go on and book your stall for there are a few remaining. Of course, today we have lots of things to talk about as women's sports is really growing. The sports bodies are also trying to invest in a lot of money. And of course, the footballers, of course, that is the females, they're getting more opportunities. We can't forget to remind you that Nalo Kenge was signed under Prozone. Of course, they are willing to sign more other girls. Later on the show, we'll also talk about, that is the Global Goals World Cup that is scheduled for the 8th of March, that is Women's Day. We have Mariam Pata, she'll be giving us an insight. We'll talk about the UPL table and lots more on the show. Welcome, ladies.
Thank you.
Thank you, Becky.
Thank you. You look so cold.
You know, it has rained today. It has rained quite a bit, and I think it has kind of knocked me off my feet.
Okay. Say hello to the viewers. Give them your Twitter handle and where they can follow you.
Of course. I'm excited to be on Sportswoman once again. My name is Faith Mirelle Kiai, right at The New Vision, and my Twitter handle is at KMirelle.
Well, it's a very good afternoon. African woman back on the show again. I told you, you've refused to appreciate my African beauty, but
it's okay.
It's all right. From Monday, I'm in an African attire. I mean, yesterday I entered our office.
Maybe you're doing that for your husband.
Sports department. And Faith was turning like, wow, this angel from Zombo.
Okay, you blow your own trumpet. Yes, say hello to the people of Zombo. You have to.
Yes, Charo Danami Zombo Tine Lena Tenu Sokago, Tene Nyutunia Amara Danami Zombo, Amara Danami West Nile, Amara Danami Africa Zokom, Sawa Moko Kendu Kwa Kendi Mi Pamondo, Pamondo. So once in a while, Makwande Wa Kendi Mamuami Matuami Africa Kakai, Ameru Magwe Danami Paida Town Council, Baga Sub County, Jumbe Neno Sportswoman Show, Kodi Zombo West Nile at large and Northern Uganda. God bless you, Mungu Medi Mungisa.
Welcome, Mariam.
Wow.
You say hello to the viewers. You can also speak to them in your language.
Actually, she speaks
Kiswahili.
Ruchiga. She's
three.
Ruchiga and
Rusoga.
Swahili. Swahili.
And Luganda, I also know.
I beat you.
Check it on. In Swahili, Rusoga. Mix.
My name is Mariam Pata. Habari zenu. Nashukuru sana kwa hapa Urban TV. Na furaha sana. Nina isanuli njiku ba wano kuyu Urban TV. Tishiba changu kuba ku sportswoman I nenda kwe baza bachala imukumpa okunaniriza
bachala
kandi na bakabare nabo nimbara musa mwe bare mnonga kwagira bachala bakuzana umpira na
Anyway, Mariam, this is a sportswoman, and this is how we do it every Thursday. Faith, take us through your highlights or lowlights of the week.
Mine is going to be kind of both. I have two. So my highlight of the week is going to be the fact that they managed to launch the Global Goals World Cup today morning. That's a very good highlight for me. East Africa. And then my low light is the Uganda Rugby Union, rugby player called Oled Joseph, the one who got involved in a nasty accident. He survived death by whisker, had brain surgery on Sunday morning. So I would say, yeah, that's my low light of the week.
I don't think I have highlights. I have only low lights only. This time round, My first low light is in Uganda. The continuous hooliganism against some of our sports personalities. And of course, I categorically talk about Sam Simba, the coach of Uganda Revenue Authority Football Club, who was attacked by a section of fans of KCCA Football Club. And adamantly, the KCCA management has kept it put, and no one is coming out to make a statement. It happened like 3 times. First was at Ndeje. Second time was when Villa was playing against police. At Lugogo. Then again, it was when KCCA had hosted Maroons Football Club. So for me, it's a low light. For me, that kind of stuff shouldn't have happened, because if you're singing, it's just more than a club. I mean, the slogan goes off. I don't know how it should be. Then my second low light is the Ethiopian athlete Abadi Addis, who died at 22 years old, was ranked 12th in the world in the men's 10,000 meters. And of course, you remember he finished number 21, I think, in the 5,000 meters. And he also finished 15th in the 2016 Olympics in Rio Janeiro, that is Brazil. So it's a low light for us Africans, losing a young athlete at 22 years only. Surely, as Africans, we feel very terrified, and you know how Ethiopia has been kind of ruling us in terms of athletes in Africa.
Okay, just in line with you about the hooliganism that is really going on each day that passes, I'm also having a low light of the poor officiation that is continuously happening, and we see the Federation not doing anything. You know, so I think we'll talk about that later on the show. Yeah, Mariam, what has been your highlight of the week?
My highlight of the week, of course, today has been the launch of the Global Goals. It's just been amazing. The rains came out so very tough, but we thank God that we had a very nice launch and the rain stabilized. And of course, one of my other highlights is having met the Secretary General Fatma Samora during the time she came to visit FUFA. It was one of those moments any woman in sports really can look up to and celebrate. So for me, those are two major things that I thank God for.
Okay. Yes. So let's begin. Who is Mariam? Because a person who is watching the show for the first time would love to know who you are and what you do.
Yes. So my name is Mariam Pata. I'm Ugandan, of course, like I said. And I've been running football programs in Kenya for the last 11 years. And I've also been doing some football projects in Iganga. And as a sportswoman, I've played football as a goalkeeper on amateur level. Don't get worried, ladies.
I'm not
She's to be a manager. So
I can tell you for free that goalkeeping is one of the toughest jobs.
Really?
I really didn't know it until I went on the pitch. So it's not very easy, but I've played as a goalkeeper, and basically because of the Global Goals. And in where I live in Kenya, I've been doing initiatives for young people and women. And I happen to now, of course, get into the Global Goals World Cup initiative. And that's how I appointed the host for this year's World Cup in Uganda here. It's exciting.
Okay. Yes. Does this happen yearly?
Yes, this tournament actually, right now it's like in its 25th edition. In a year like just 2020, we have about 15 tournaments happening. Okay. And on the African continent, we have Uganda hosting, Nigeria hosting. Nigeria.
So that means that we'll be having ours.
Yes, but they will also be having, although it's on different months.
Oh, okay.
Like Nigeria is actually on 20th March, ours is on 8th March, and Morocco is in July. And we have other countries. We have India, we have Colombia hosting, we have the US, we have...
So are we going to see Indians with the saris in the pitch?
I'm telling you.
how many teams have so far registered, and how much is the registration?
So the registration one for community teams is free of charge, because this is...
Okay, like ours that we are registering.
Abachara Simile. That one, I already put a tick on it.
Okay.
You are team number 20. 29.
Okay.
Yes.
Faith.
Yes.
Water carrier.
So you're going to play.
You have to be on the pitch.
Water carrier. I'm certified.
You have to proudly. Be on the pitch. So the Global Goals, like I said, is an amateur tournament for women. Women like you and me here, to play for advocacy, to advocate for the Sustainable Development Goals. And so far we have 29 teams, including yours. Yes. 6 teams are from Kenya, 2 teams from Tanzania, and the rest are from Uganda. And the most interesting aspect about this particular edition is that we have seen for the first time grandmothers registering for the tournament. Yes, grandmothers. So we have a team called the Abigail's Grandmas. They are amazing, energetic grandmothers. Yes. And you know, the other interesting thing is that each team picks on a goal. So your team has to look for pick on a goal, because again we want to promote the SDGs.
Yes, of course.
So you pick on a goal. So like these grandmothers picked on goal 8. They are saying they want their grandchildren to stop selling maize on the road. They want decent jobs.
And show it in the company.
I think 10 suits us.
Yes. Decent. They want decent jobs.
They want this one.
Yes.
Economic.
Which one should they pick for us?
10.
10.
10.
You
want 10. Reduce inequalities.
Yes.
Yeah. So we are picking reduce inequalities.
And why? Why are you picking it on?
Why I'm picking it is basically because we are having so much inequalities moving around in the world.
Yes.
And it is not only against women, but even the men.
Uh-huh.
And actually, right now, the men are even more
discriminated
in society. And then the elderly.
Yes.
And the vulnerable children.
Yes.
Those are the people who I look at up to so much.
Yes.
And then most importantly are the women in sports.
Yes.
There's so much inequality in terms of even pay itself, in terms of employment.
Exactly, true.
So those are the things.
Oh, that's brilliant. That's brilliant. You guys are up.
Thank you.
You are up there because
you
already know so much about the Global Goals. So I'm so happy, and I mean, I must commend you because as women in sports, it's been a journey for us. And to be able to even have a show like this, it's quite amazing.
It's the only show, by the way, in Uganda. The whole country, like probably could even be East Africa, because you watch these TV stations and you never get any show that is basically run by women.
And you're right, because I haven't heard of it in Kenya as well, because there are so many other channels or shows for sports, but not specifically targeting women. So
You didn't project the registration fee well.
The registration fee for corporates is 2 million. And that money, of course, again, like I said, it's money to help us with the logistics.
Yes.
Hosting a World Cup, as I keep telling the men that, you know, women are bringing the World Cup to Uganda.
Mm-hmm.
We need support. It's not very easy. We want to, I have been able to attend the one in Nairobi and South Africa. And, of course, I've seen the others on social media and experienced what they are doing. They put up a really fantastic show.
Okay.
They give it the feel of a World Cup. There's so much excitement, color. So we also want to be able to be supported, to be able to make it, show the world that Uganda is here and we are capable of hosting such tournaments.
So things like jazzes.
Yes.
Are you guys going to give us, or it is us, the players?
Now, the most interesting thing is that each team is being encouraged to create a jazz.
Be creative. Since you're into African things, you might as well.
Okay, Mariam.
Exactly.
You must be Max, and I want you to call upon all the sports lovers.
Yes.
There couldn't be even sports lovers or communities to come and register and be part of this.
Yes, I want to just commend your job and thank you so much for hosting me. I want to just encourage women, you know, grandmothers, mothers, sisters out there on 8th March. Come join us at Star Times, Lugogo Stadium, right here in Uganda, Kampala. Come and enjoy, celebrate the day with us. We are starting at 8 a.m. and hopefully be finished by 6 p.m. So come, let us try and change society using football. It's a powerful tool. I've seen it work, and I know it is not going to leave Uganda the same. So thank you so much.
Okay, thank you, Maren.
Thank you.
Okay, let's go for a short commercial break. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Sportswoman is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.